Okay, so today I need to get the floating memory of the new data pool. Need to get that kind of sorted. Let's reopen this and reopen. Where is it? Oh, right, it's in extras, right? For the benchmark. Yes, there we go. This, the data pool. Put these to the side. Open that up. Okay, and it's trying to shrink this number way down. I mean, I shrunk that number to nothing, which is great improvement. Okay, actually, before I go on with that, are there any other really easy things? Prep data is 4 to 10. Destinations, that's kind of required. So you have to go through and find out where everything's going on the... Yeah, can't really. Wait, this is 21 and 8. If, where is it? This. What if I take this out, Ken, does this change? Okay, actually, let's do a second for entropy. 21, 20 to 10, and 20 and 8. Okay, 21, 22, and 8. Put this out. Okay, go. 22 and 8, 22 and 8, 22 and 8, 22 and 8. 81 and 5. So it, okay. Ah, interesting. This is interesting. If you on the, it's faster to have the lower bound search, it's faster on the small insertions, but slower on the larger ones. That's an interesting thing I'm going to do for a trade-off, actually. Like, if only run this check on certain data sizes, maybe? Whatever. I'd rather have the slightly better overall case, which is going to have that. Anything else? I mean, that's really... Okay. I got to do floating memory. Floating memory. I don't have to worry about the removed. It's just on the main memory. So one of the first things I'm going to require is to have added as part of the regular... Okay, where the hell is main storage? M stored, so that's the number stored, and we need to have a size T of M float start. So we can start at 0, why not? I mean, the other thing I can do, actually, is what if I was to increase this to... No, because I wouldn't... That would affect the larger cases. Well, this larger case, I bet. So if I was to... Calc. Add that. Whoop. 10, 24 times 16. Sixteen, 384. Okay, let's try that. 16384. Try that. Okay, let's see. 550, 619, 600, 660. So that's kind of an improvement. 94, 95, 76, 70. I mean, that is an improvement for sure. But that's just meaning... That just means, like, that doesn't actually help too much on this case. Like, the large multi-move case. That's unfortunate. Okay, floating storage. Again, back to basics. Hmm. Actually, hold on. In my case, okay, no, I'm not actually going to do this. Because now that I'm thinking about it, that test seed data, that is fully randomized data, which means they're all over, like they're pretty evenly distributed throughout the entire UN32 set of values. Realistically, in this engine, all other than the initial setup where you're loading everything, when you're loading up all the data sets, which are the initial sets, like starting at base at group zero to whatever. After that point, almost practically all of the data, all the changes, insertions, removals, and what have you, updates will be occurring at the end of each of these. So realistically, if I go to the source and find it, because I've set up the yeah, we are like the persistent indices, the temporary indices, like these groups are whoops. These groups are at the very okay. These groups are at the very end of the group values, the group sets. Like it's the max value minus one. And yeah, that and minus one. So all of the dynamic data is always going to be at the end of these. So me doing dynamic floating memory nonsense isn't really going to help the situation. This just represents the worst case, which is unfortunate. But realistically, it's usually not going to be that bad. It'll be. Realistically, it'll almost always be at the end. In the end half, maybe. And I guess I'll just have to be willing to take the hit for the negative cases, or rather make changes to things like the expansion rate, which reminds me that if I'm not going to be doing anything to do with the floating memory, I mean, I'd like to keep that idea in the back of my head, but it's really complicated and I don't really know how to do it. So I'm just gonna blather on and move to the side and say, hey, let's do something else, like expansion rate. I need to have the ability to update and check the expansion rate. So something like that goes along the capacity. So these all like lowercase things kind of are publicly anyways. Return M expansion rate. Equals okay, we do something like that. And I'm not even going to bother returning the old one. It just is. Or do I wanna? Is there? Maybe. No. Not worth it. If you want to get it, you get it first. If you need it, get it first, and then set it. And then this way I can just reset. Expansion rate set and get. Simple enough. Is there anything else I would like to do? I need to add this to be tested. Do I actually want to, I'm trying to think, do I want to, do I want to have a constructor that allows this to be set, or just have it like set the 8,000? Because 8,000 may be just too way larger than you need for most cases. Perhaps I should have it at set at a much lower rate, like 128, and then have the option for something else. I'm thinking like yeah. That I'll do that. So pool data pool. Do we have a constructor? We do not, but we can add it. Equals 128 or 256 object. 256. No, 128. It's fairly small. Something like that. Is there anything else I want to do with this? Set that to 0. Can I just split this to the right? What I'll do then is I'll split it into the, I'm going to split the implementation, the declaration from the implementation, with the declaration from the definition of the template. So I don't have like this stuff in line, at least not in the head, at least not here. So I'll clean this up a little bit. Especially these cases, maybe? Yeah. Okay. So insert expansion rate that. Okay, here we go. Insert sync and stuff. Implementation of the data pool. Okay. There we go. Let's get rid of the timing. I'm not even going to bother with that anymore. That's down. Time sync times sunk times sync. There we go. Clock update. So we got rid of clock, which is great. Which means we no longer require chrono, easy clock anymore. It's cleaned up. Okay, that's also another thing. Do I need foeId? The answer really should be no. Realistically, this will be a generic type. This is the only thing. This foeId is the only thing that this that makes this be a part of foeECS. I could move it to foe because it's a pretty generic thing, if not for this. So two things. First of all, are there any changes here? Okay. Stage that. Expansion rate stuff. And we got. Okay, no. First of all, we'll change it so that we just add the expansion rate stuff. And then I need to actually have it here. So, it's 128 right now. We add that, these test cases. We need to remove timing from this. Okay. What do we got going on here? Let me guess. The latest one I have available for these goes down to 177, and I'm going to guess that if I go to user, include, actually, home. It'll be like 178. Okay, I just need to quickly update that. I'll be right back. And then, here it is. So let's make sure this is the this is not quite the latest one. The latest one. So we got up to. Okay, this is from the last thing, the time I worked here. So. Generate a new set. Got up to 178. And. Oh! Obviously, I haven't rebuilt it on here since. Whoa! Get rid of the tests, right? That's why. go. That should at least give us 178. Yeah, okay. Yep. Okay. And then actually, let's re-enable these so we know build. Okay. Const cast from const void const star. Oh, what is this? To void star is not allowed. I'm sorry. For which one? Who are we talking about? What is this? Compute unit, what the hell is this? Oh, it's a new type. Classic workaround. It's fixed, swear, I swear. I'll look into that later. But right now, I need something that works on 178, and I'm not using any of NVIDIA's fancy compute unit nonsense. So, do 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 do. Are we not going to look at the fact that I updated this again? Okay, what was it? Struct cleanup, right? Yeah. I just want to open the file, yo. I didn't think this was that hard. Get rid of this. Okay, we're at the yeah, okay, now we added everything. Okay, now we're gonna do it. Put that up. Gotta fix that brand new struct of hell that NVIDIA has introduced. Thank you. Gotta go back. Let's do this on the side. Back up to external. Minilibs. Vulkan. Sorry? Did I just change? Oh, he's still there. Okay, we're. Yeah, we're in here. Okay. And then we're updating this. Fantastic. Yeah, relinking these guys for the new headers. Oh, come on. Like, it's not even doing that much. Okay, at least this is done. Okay, got that. Editability. So now I'll do this. Add a constructor for data pool. Okay, now I'm going to close that. Don't really, no. What do I need? I don't really need anything else other than this. So what I'm going to do is, at the bottom of this, we're going to include ECS data pool dot implementation dot HPP. Okay, so what's going to happen is I'm going to shift the functions over. Okay. Okay. Who needs this? Are we sure about this? That seems fine. Okay. The idea of doing this is that I get to clean up the signature declaration of this. Because, again, 90% of people won't even have to look at this stuff. They just need to look at, like, what can I do publicly and then privately. Well, just publicly, really. This is not the whole thing. Whoops. Should I with these? I don't. I could just turn them into one-liners. And it's still going to be templated. Like, it's still going to be inline because the implementation will still be included. It's just, again, yeah, I'm just cleaning up the declaration point. Is this not? Ooh, no, it's a pointer. Oof. I don't know if I can even do this. Okay, back up. Leave these out for the moment. Make sure what I have already is working, is going to work. What's wrong here? Okay. Cannot add a default template argument to the definition of a member. Is that because of over? Oh, in here I can't add the default equals zero. Okay, that's still looking good, right? Make test, right? Yeah, okay. Next. This is an interesting one. I'm not sure if the it'll still accept the auto. Even if it is defined inline just a little bit later. That is a no-go. Crap. This is not great. Oh, wait, hold on. Whoops. Maybe that's why. Okay, my bad. Phew. We've got the removal stuff.
as equal zeros. Clear removed. And then we've got the insert pass and the remove pass right here. Ooh. Oh, yes. And there we go. Okay, hold on. That was still on that? That must have a... Dang it. Wait. Crap. Save that. Go back here. Remove. What is it? This. Ah, this function right here. Okay, I'm going to bet I must have a issue on in the thread library somehow. Some thread contention issue or whatever. Something somewhere. Slightly reorder all this stuff. This is quite a fair-sized public interface. Does it at least work right now? Oh, that really burns me still. So going from like a 500 line file to 150, still not great, plus another 550 line file. It's larger than it was originally because I got all these extra lines to do with the templating stuff. Unfortunate. Do I need share mutex? No. Do I need C string here? The answer is no. I need it in here. I need mutex. Do I have a, I have a vector somewhere, right? Vector, yes. Vector and mutex. That's what I need up here. This is bringing in C standard lib, tuple, C standard def. I need tuple in here as well for this right here. Just say auto pointer. Let's see if I can get some documentation into here as well. The closing of the data pool will also require me to go through multi-deleted main storage and clearing of removed. Oh, I already do that here, don't I? What does that do? Multi-delete that. Yeah, okay, so I'm good. I'm good. I'm good. Any order. Made accessible. Are discarded data. That note, this is very boring stuff, I know. I apologize. Not really. It's just a new rate of return the number of insert. Ooh, why is this here? Inserted, insert, pass. Here. together and insert remove, then we've got these. That's actually something I need to consider, is the fact that I'm not reducing the size of anything after the first time. And I probably should, or have the ability to tweak it, you know, up and customize the size of it based on, I would presume to be data that developers would already know beforehand. Like, oh, this, you know, this class always has like 16 things to remove every time, so just keep it as regular size 16, expand it if necessary, but otherwise shrink it back down. Or something. I don't need to say cycle, it's getting a bit redundant. Number of items. source. Okay, that's a whole bunch of stuff. So we'll just kind of update this. So data pool that we've got single. Okay, these in place. And multi-delete need to move down to just after CRM end. Right here. Okay, multi-move, multi-delete, then we got clear inserted. Hold on, I'm missing something, aren't I? How am I missing half these things? I'm getting all this stuff, right? Yes. Those right here. Then we got clear inserted. there. And clear removed. I'm just trying to get the layout of this to match with the layout of the functions here. So it's a bit easier to find things in the future. CRM stuff. From sequential search, so we got removed. That's a count one. So remove, okay, these two both moving up. So got that removed, goes to wherever insert is. Just here, insert, removed. These are both moving up to just before sequential search. Then we've got exist, then we've got removed, then we've got inserted somewhere. Right here. I'm not entirely settled on this stuff yet, or because it's these aren't really accessors or iterators; they're just pointers. So maybe I'll just call them like rm begin data. Like I'll suffix data onto these, or prefix like data rm begin data. Something, I don't know, something like that. I'm not entirely happy about this stuff. The rest of this class is pretty okay. I can live with. I think I can live with it. Now I'm just going to do that. Okay, I need to. Still works, right? Okay. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to get rid of the requirement for foeId here. I'm going to actually make it just part of the template. So it'll be like template type name, ID type, like that. We'll just replace all of these with that. ID type, ID type, ID type. So it could be foeId, it could be like foe resource ID, it could be a unit, it could be any numerical type. Means we don't need that anymore. So that means we need to do this. So type name that becomes all 443, and we're going to do the same thing here. Like that. Maybe not. What's going on? Oh, because it's where's the declaration of the dang thing? Okay, we don't need it there. We need it here, right? Yes. Yes. Okay.
Okay. So what's wrong now? Pool store that, P store, offset ID, components. Oh, right. Yeah, okay. That makes sense. No matching function called it. Are you still on about this? Oh, wow. Come on. I'm sorry. No known conversion from tuple unsigned int to. Insert that components. Yeah. Down here in the this, we got a standard tuple of this and that. Unsigned int. So then why is this fourth argument of this? 1, 2, 3, 4. Same thing here. I don't get it. Okay. So I'm going to assume that this is something up here that I'm just screwing up. So we've got this times, yeah, size of that. Okay. Single in place. This is. There's no other changes. It's not like. Tuple type? Is that screwing up? Sorry. Up here, tuple type. foeId to ID type. No, that's a straight conversion. Ah. Got an extra one here. Like that, right? On the insert pass, okay. 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 Oh. Yes, changing up the data pool types. This will be... Okay. So we got these things, we converted up to using a generic type. If I'm going to do this, I should also actually should specify this actually in the documentation right here. Param ID type. Is it optional data? No, it has to have it at least. Piece of data. I need to have at least one piece of data because, why? The standard map needs it. If it was to move away from standard map, I could actually make this just have zero components. But it's not worth it. Not right now. added that. Now, since it's divorced from this, from the ID type, now I can actually shift these to regular foeId. Just foe, like foe include data pool right here. Doesn't have to be part of foeECS anymore. Yes, no, that's, those have been moved already. Okay. Up, 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 up. This is changing up to no longer require that. Like that. What I'll do here is I'll have a new thing. It's like component data, which will just be this template with like foeId put in there as well. So that all you have to do is define the components afterwards. And then I can have a separate one for the resource. So I don't have to specify foeId or foeResource ID everywhere. Yeah. We can move extras up to here. We also move these three up to here. Move this. Put them up here. CD. Okay, that needs to be changed as well. It's no longer that. It's don't need that anymore. It's not foeECS, it's just foe data pool benchmark. Just require foe. I don't need that anymore either, because instead of foeId, it's now going to be we'll just do this, okay? Bam. U164 will be slower. But I'm fine with this. Mm-hmm. These are mostly just moves or renames. Divorced from it's not changed. Good. Bam. Okay, I think I'll call it there for iteration cleanup of the type. And with this, what was I even doing this all for? I was doing this for physics implementation to figure out insertion and deletion, removal of items. So next time, on a very special session, I'm going to go back to the implementation of physics, and I'm going to use this system to get a more proper implementation rather than that rickety duct taped and twine solution. I'm going to get something a bit more realistic and systemic that will actually, I will be using moving forward, as well as probably, because there's several other types that can basically do the same thing here. I'll also be, if I can find it, state pools. Moving these other state pools over. Well, maybe not this one. This one doesn't really make as much sense. Or would it? It might. It might. Actually, and I'll be adding a benchmark to see like if the time it takes for me to find things in compared to the map to the allocation type, because that's actually another thing I should really look at, is like finding things randomly, basically. Can I? And that's all for next time. Cheers.